Australians hold the world record at 4:03.840, set at the world titles in Hamar, Norway in 1993. And in the world championships last year, Australia rode 4:05.0. So if they can repeat that here today, well, they'll certainly be the fastest qualifier by a long, long way. That'd put them about 6 seconds in, 5 seconds in front of the opposition. But that's not surprising, because in qualifying for the Worlds last year, they were in fact 4 seconds faster than the next best. So that's how dominant Australia is at the moment in teams pursuiting. We've won 2 world titles in the last 3 years, and the Australians here are on the line, and this should be something special. Although, with what we've seen so far in cycling, don't count your chickens.
That's right. I don't think everybody expected the French to be so strong, and the Italians. Let's see, Australia is normally a traditionally a very strong cycling nation on the track. It's proven in the last 10 years that we're up there with the best. So that's the 30-second mark, 30 seconds before the four Australians are going to head off here. Now, in a team event like this, they usually end up 20 seconds faster than what an individual rider goes at. And, you know, you've got to remember, this is a top level. This is looking at world championship times here. See the riders lining up there rather nervously, standing on the line. They've been training for this. Well, you didn't see them warming up. They came in at the last moment, and this is the moment they've been waiting for.
The Australians get off the line in the team's pursuit. They're the top seeds as a result of winning the world titles last year, and leading them out is Tim O'Shaughnessy, who was a member of that world championship team last year, along with Stuart O'Grady. Fred Aitken was a member of the team in 93, which broke the world record. And Dean Woods is in here, the veteran of the team, at 30 years of age. He was a gold medalist way back in Los Angeles in 1984 in this event.
So, riding very strongly, smoothly. In an event like this, the strongest rider is only as good as the weakest rider. And these are all very, very evenly matched. Dean Woods, he took a bit of sabbatical there a few years ago. He rode on the European professional road circuit for a while. He was still riding the track in the winter, but I think this is what's given him a lot of extra stamina. You know, he's been around since 88. He's been professional, but before that, of course, he was in the winning team in Los Angeles.
Coming up to complete 1 kilometre, France's fastest time, 1:05.929.
So it's the fastest time so far.
So Australia right there and looking good. Well, when you go in as favourites, as Shane Kelly well knows, it doesn't always pan out. But so far, the Australians' favouritism well justified.
Yeah, the Americans were off, interestingly enough, just a few moments ago, a couple of teams back, and they started very strongly. They posted the fastest times on the board up until the last kilometre. And then they floundered a bit, lost a couple of seconds, and ended up going back to third or fourth place.
And when the lead rider, who at the moment is Brett Aitken, swings up the track, he'll rejoin the team at the back, and what you're looking for is just centimetres in between wheels, and they really have to orchestrate this just about like a ballet. This is Charlie Walsh's favourite event. He's been coaching Australian teams since the late 70s. He prepared the Commonwealth Games team in Brisbane in 1982, and he's won world titles and Olympic gold medal. He's had world records, and this is the one he really wants, and so do we all.
Of course, when you swing up, like Drew was saying, you want to drop back as close as you can to the last position. If there's a centimetre there, it's a centimetre too much. You want to come in really close to get the most effect of the slipstream caused by the team.
At the completion of 2 kilometres, halfway mark, 2:05.16, the Australians 2 seconds faster than the Frenchmen at the same stage.
Now, it's going to be difficult for them to get a world record, I think, right now, because the fastest time so far is still 6 seconds outside of that that world record. But we've seen it done here the last couple of days. You never know.
Well, we saw 2 world records in individual pursuiting with the Italian, and might we see one either here or later on in the series by the team's pursuit. Incidentally, the effect of individual pursuiting on the teams is shown in that France is fastest in the team, and they had Ermineau, the silver medalist in the individual, and Italy are second fastest, and they had Colonelli in their team, who was, of course, the gold medalist. Australia have rested the bronze medalist, Brad McGee, but we have 6 strong pursuiters, and they can all put their hands up and compete for the gold medal. 3:07 at the end of 3 kilometres, so at this stage about 1.2 seconds faster than the previous fastest, French.
Yeah, still going very strongly at the moment. See a bit of a gap there last wheel, but still a very complete unit. staying very, very tight. And, well, they're looking like they're going to get the best time at this stage.
So, two laps to go here, and the Australian still has a foursome. The fastest time is taken by the rear wheel of the third rider as he goes across the line. So they don't all have to finish. One man can drop off. And the Australians, though, are sticking as a foursome as they get the bell lap. Australians clearly the fastest in qualifying in the team's pursuit. Go, Aussies, go! And the American crowd rising to them. The reigning world champions come to the line as a foursome. Magnificent ride by Australia, but 4:09.71, and all of a sudden, towards
second
the
best
end,
time is what I see.
They lost the time to the Frenchman in about the last two-thirds of a kilometre, and Australia are third fastest at 4:09.771 behind France and Italy.